30-odd years. I was suicidal. I had a lot of violence in the early 80s, well, up to 70s and 80s.
Yeah.
Because I had years of abuse of this child, so I ran away from home from 11. From about 9 to about 12. Anyway, stealing to survive. Then I went to prison school, come out, and I started stealing for drink. I ended up in bosses, prison schools, detention centres, prisons,
okay.
All sorts of things. All because of what I had as a child, you know. And
yeah.
I thought drink was the answer, but it didn't got me in so much trouble
yeah.
and violence. So anyway, I had many Christians praying for me later on in life because I was married twice, ex-minor as well.
Yeah.
And I ended up on the streets for 6 years because my second wife left me. And then I mixed with the alcoholics and I came like an animal, a real violent, and got yeah. a lot of trouble. Anyway, but I had Christians coming in to us, giving us soup and clothes and stuff, and
yeah.
talking to us about Jesus. In the beginning, I didn't want to know, you know. I thought, get away, I don't want to hear you.
Yeah.
But after some time, we got to know him, and I saw something different in his. I thought they really cared about us.
Yeah.
So it went from there. And anyway, I had him praying first. I had, they set me free, God set me free of drink, smoking, and drugs. And suicide, I tried to kill myself many, many times. God
really?
Set me free, yeah. And, you know, I sort of had a lot of trouble with my sort of mental mind, you know, thoughts, you know, I just wanted to end it. But God has set me free of all that now.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I go around telling people what Jesus done for me, just giving people hope in this
yeah.
world that Jesus is real.
Yeah.
Just call out to him. And he'll answer, just ask God to forgive his sins and repent of them. Just be Lord and Savior, and it's as simple as that.
Mm.
Nothing. There won't be like a bag in the sky. God will talk to you in his timing
yeah.
to people. Because when I had Christians praying for me, I said, well, where's all these prayers, you know, answers? But looking back over the years, God was answering them.
Yeah.
And I thought they were coincidences, but they weren't. They were God instances.
Oh, really?
So I'll give you one more before I go,
yeah.
because I don't want to bore you too much.
No, you're right. I'm
and,
here.
In the 80s, I was jumping the trains all over the country,
yeah.
begging. I didn't think I'd ever see the day I'd beg for drink, but I made a lot of money with that. Drink was my thing.
Yeah.
I was begging. Well, anyway, wherever I jumped off a train, if I went to Birmingham, if I was Southampton, London, wherever.
Yeah.
There was Christians coming on to me wherever I went. I thought, this is crazy, because I used to try and hide from the alcoholic. Because
yeah, yeah.
once you see you have drink, you get in fights, all sorts of things.
Yeah.
But anyway, I went back to Swansea a few months later, or a few weeks, I can't remember now.
Yeah.
And I told him, I met up with my Christian friends, and I told him what happened, and he smiled. He said, Peter, I prayed that God would send Christians on to you wherever I went. And that's what happened. So God answered his prayer.
Oh, really?
So, yeah, so I just tell people there's
Are hope. You going up to the cross here, there?
No, I got up here. Oh, they've done the cross now, is it? They
yeah, but what's the reason, like, who's done that? Do you know anything
I think,
about
yeah,
that?
Yeah, it's one. Oh, isn't that amazing that I'm talking to you and you've just seen the cross?
I've just been to the cross
wow.
to go and visit it now.
Praise
yeah.
God, lovely. Yeah, apparently it's the one that owns the field right at the back.
Yeah, it is, yeah.
Yeah, and...
it overlooks the A1. I've literally
right.
just been up there now.
Oh, you see it
take
there.
Some photos, yeah.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah.
This was meant to be like...
Yeah, yeah. And funny you say about alcohol and smoking,
yeah.
I actually... was an alcoholic myself, and I quit 3 years ago.
Have you?
Yeah, and I quit smoking as well at the same time.
Wow, praise God. So. I see that this was meant. You know, sometimes I talk to people, I go on, like a few, I've spoken to three already, the fourth, and then at times I leave them go, you know, bottle out,
yeah.
to be honest. You know, I don't find it easy just going on to strangers.
No,
and
no.
Saying, you're mad, get away, leave me alone and all that. You know, I used to be like
well, you
that.
Didn't come up to me aggressive or threatening
no,
me.
Oh,
which
no,
you,
I'd never do
you know
that.
You know what I mean? So
you know,
why,
a big guy
why,
anyway.
Why wouldn't I want to talk
yeah,
to you? Do you
yeah.
know what I mean? It's nice
but
to,
some
for people to be friendly to each
yeah,
other, isn't it? So.
A lot of people don't want to know. It's a lot of people hurting people out there.
Yeah, there is, yeah.
And they think, well, no, if God's real, why do you, probably like myself, why do you allow this? But if he just let me just talk to them for a minute, maybe they'll call out to them. Who
yeah,
knows,
yeah, who knows, yeah.
Well,
does it hurt to have a conversation? That's me, I'm Paul anyway.
Jesus, what's his name, Paul?
Paul, yeah.
Paul, Peter, my name is
yeah,
Peter,
yeah.
Paul.
Yeah, yeah, we were sat on a wall once, weren't we? One threw away and then the other one come back.
Yeah. I thought it was me and you for a minute. I was thinking, but I don't remember.
Peter and Paul. See you later, Peter, that's me. Yeah, have a good day. Thank you very much.
I remember Jesus loves you.
Yeah, I knew, mate, I knew. Thank you.